name's Callum Hancock. I'm 21 years old. I'm a professional boxer. I box at Brendan Ingalls in Sheffield, Winkerbank, under his watchful eye. I had a successful amateur record with 21 fights, 4 losses, 14 stoppages. My nickname's the Hitman. The reason for that is because I got badly bullied growing up as a kid. All the kids found me an easy target to pick on because I'd always fight back and fought our game. Every time they beat me up, I'd always tell them I'd get them back. Like, boxing to me, it's the ultimate sport, and their family, Brendan, Dominic, John, their talents are second to none. They're in gym 24/7, that's all they do, they live and breathe boxing, and to be the best, you've got to be with the best, and I believe it's them. Over the years, Brendan's had turned out boxers, world champions, Commonwealth champions, European champions, British, every single belt he's had them all. Look at Prince Nazim, Junior Witter, Johnny Nelson, Ryan Rhodes. I want to be amongst them names because that's what I want, that's what I've dreamt of as a little boy. I didn't think it was going to happen, but it is starting to happen. There's no reason why it can't happen. I'm only doing what they've done, and that's hard work, dedication, day in, day out in the gym. The fire's deep in my stomach. It's what I want to do. I love to fight. I've always been able to fight, but now I'm taking it that step further, and I'm mastering how to fight, not just a fight on the street anymore to me. I've had loads of them. But now it's in ring. Brendan's took a step back with me and told me how to calm down and everything. He's teaching me well.
So you don't have to do one thing right, you've got to do everything right. And then you're responsible. When that bell goes, I get out, you're in there by yourself. I can help you when you come back to the corner. You don't train right, you mess around, you don't get the better of proper time, you don't eat properly. Time in the ring.
It's all about sacrifices, isn't it, Brendan? It's not one of the hardest sports, it's the hardest.
It's the hardest sports. We must be doing something right because we keep turning out champions.
Proof's in the pudding. My first pro fight, it was May 12th on Kid Gallard's undercard at Sheffield Hillsborough Leisure Centre. I boxed 4 3-minute rounds, first time I've ever done a 3-minute round in my life. Every 3-minute round I'd stopped him straight away, and the kid were a tough kid. He knew how to look after himself, knew what game's about. Yeah, I've got a hell of a long way to go. If I ever believe I'm finished article, I'm a fool and I've lost already. I'm learning every day. Every time I go in my gym, I'm learning something new, whether it's my diet, my training, my boxing, whatever it is, I'm learning all the time. When I was growing up, this area is called Eckington Youth Club. We all used to knock about on here all the time, all the lads, girls. This Friday and Saturday night, this is where it used to happen. And this person here, Jinnah, his real name's Chris Hazelhurst. He tragically passed away, he got killed in a car accident, him and his mate, best mate Bingham. And his memorial's on the wall next door. He's also got a signed wall. And we all paid respect coming down watching we got a professional spray artist in to come and spray all this. On Eckington Hill there's a lamppost, and tragically they were messing about, young and daft. They'd had some drugs and what have you, flying down that hill and beat lamppost, paid the price in the most horrific way you can imagine. His brother, he was a year above me, Nick Hazelhurst, and I'm good mates with Nick. And Jinnah, he used to take us fishing and what have you. Impact what it had on myself was big, because my mum and his mum are like the good mates, very good mates, like best mates if you want to say. And growing up, always being next to Jinnah were like a part of my life, and then all of a sudden for him to be taken away were horrible. But it upset his brother and his mum, so it had a big impact. And kids, they should look at that and like realise in their heads that drugs and alcohol whilst driving is a definite no-no. Yeah. At the time when Jinnah passed away, it's just when I was getting into my boxing, just when I'd started. And I, as horrible as this sounds, I kind of looked at that saying, I don't want to go down that path. I don't want to do that. And I think other kids need to as well. It's horrible what happened to Jinnah and Bingham, but it did happen. It shouldn't have happened. They should have never put themselves in that situation. And they need to, other kids need to look at them and say, no, that's not the way. Yeah, to all little kids round here, it's great because they look up to me. When I'm out running and that, they stop me and they ask for a photo or my signature and that, and it motivates you, it really does. I've been in their shoes, I've been through that, and they know themselves what I was like at school. I were a rebel, I weren't. Anyone thinks I'm a blue-eyed boy, I'm not. Kids from round Eckington to look at me and think like, Callum Hancock's done it, I can do it. So that's all it is, it's hard work, dedication. There's no secrets to it, there's no special ways or magic water, as you say when you're a kid. Everything's hard work, and we can do it. You just need to get off the backside and do it. Put that game console down, stop playing COD, and get to the gym. I've got the best support. Like, on my first fight, I turned out 300-400 fans, and that's a lot to ask. The support I've got around here is unbelievable. I'm so grateful for it. All people like in here, Ink Youth Club, they brought me through ranks. My mum and dad, they're behind me every step of the way, and not a lot of people can say that about my mum and dad. I've got a great family behind me.